you let everyone go before me, because I might slow you down. So
I'll let the boys go first, we'll say, because, you know, they can help us.
Just in case I fall, I was off landing, no, not really.
I'll go first, then you come in front of me and then he goes.
And this floor's about
1 minute.
Yeah. Mind the steps.
Exactly as it was at 11:30 in the morning on the 15th of September 1940. commissioned in 1973 as a RA4 development site, and this is when this room was rebuilt. Everything in this room is original, with the information of one man and one man alone, and that is the controller who sat overlooking the table in the middle cabinet, the outbreak of the war. So how long did that take to build it? February. Imagine digging a big hole in the ground, building this building inside it, equipping it, and then putting the earth in above it. Of course, there was no earth and safety in those days. Right. When the building was commissioned, the personnel in the building, there were 40 personnel per shift. You had three shifts. The next slide on the board is available in 30 minutes. That all important 30 minutes. The 30 minutes warning on the radar. The controller sitting in his cabin has to decide whether these signals that he's receiving could be genuine raiders or not. Where these enemy aircraft are coming from, where they're headed to. He has to decide which squadrons he starts to get ready. So he will send signals out to the airfields, and in this particular example, Biggin Hill, get 972-92 available. So the next light will come on up is they're now available. That means now that the pilots are kicked out, the aircraft is to start to run the engines on the aircraft, and the aircraft are ready for use. The next thing you decided are I'm going to make use of these aircraft to make orders to readiness. This is now when the pilots that you've seen in pictures on films, etc., where the pilots are running across the field into their aircraft. At readiness, that means that the pilots now are in their aircraft and all to standby. That means basically get ready to take off. They are now at standby. That is one of the most important lights on this board at the moment. The pilots are sitting in the aircraft, the engines are running, and they're now waiting for orders to be dispatched. The engines on a hurricane Spitfire are air-cooled, which basically means they've got to be flying to cool. Otherwise, if they're just sitting idly on the airfield, the engines are getting hotter and hotter, and of course, if you get a hot engine, the engine seizes up and it's no use. So we've got a maximum of 5 minutes now to decide whether to scramble the aircraft or to bend them down. So we now decide the next slide that comes along is to order to intercept.
base being Fighter Airfield southeast and east of London. In other words, to control, it looks the same as it did this morning. But too early to judge. It could be London itself. All available squadrons at readiness. Let's hear from the Observer Corps as soon as possible.
Those are hostile bombers. Hansel Hansel left. They now take direction north on 8181.
So it's the airfields again. Scramble five squadrons, Manston and Lim. Sussex, summer 1940, any afternoon, any day of the week. Report first wave of Heinkels unloading on Biggin Hill. That's the fourth time for Biggin Hill this week. But they won't be doing it for long. From radar. Another 40 plus over Abbeville and Boulogne. Is this another major effort, or is it that convoy in the channel that they're after? All right, scramble four squadrons, Debden. No doubt about it now. It's the convoy in the Straits of Dover. Stukas again. But they're taking a chance. They're dead meat for fighters. Observer Corps reports enemy breaking it up already. Losses on both sides. Hard to tell yet whose and how many. Well, that's it seems, for today. Please let us know as soon as possible how many bits and pieces lying around.
Back down to the road.